some sins you get into, you're going to need more help to get out of it.
Jesus said, this kind going not out, but by prayer and fasting. Sometimes we can confess our sin and get back into right standing with God.
Yes.
And then there are times that God must do a mighty, mighty, wonderful work of miracle to restore us to the fold. So then we are careful that we walk not in sin, that we stay not in sin, but that we seek the mind of God and say, Lord, place me on higher ground. That we come to God and we say, Lord, I need you to do a work in my life. Blessed be the name of God. Why? Because I noticed that I was slipping away from God, and I got further and further and further. And the further away from God I got, the harder it was to get back to God. So then James said, well, what you need to do is draw nigh to God. If you draw nigh to God, God will draw nigh to you. Again, when the wicked turn away from his wickedness and do that which is lawful and right. Somebody said right.
Right.
He shall save his soul.
Oh, yeah.
You can be in a position where you feel there's no hope. I've stayed away for too long.
All right.
I cannot even feel the Spirit of God anymore. I can no longer hear the voice of God talking to me. I don't even remember John 3:16. I don't remember the word that used to be hidden in my heart to keep me from sinning. But now sin is just drawing and pulling and aggravating my life. But now, Lord, I come before your throne of grace. That we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Lord, I just want to come to you in a spirit of forgiveness and thankfulness and to just get it right with you, Lord. Amen. You can say that. Amen. The God that we serve has welcomed us back into his arms. We too, we all have strayed away like the prodigal son and had to call upon God with uplifted arms and outstretched hands and say, Lord, call me back into your fold that I may be able to worship you in spirit and worship you in truth. Amen. Need not think that you are so far away from God that God doesn't hear your cry. Well, if you feel that way, answer my question, is there anything too hard? Is there anything too hard for the Lord? Blessed be the name of God. Our God have saved a many that strayed from him, even the patriarchs that sometime lost their ways. But yet, God, being ever merciful, ever loving God, has always made preparation to redeem mankind. He's always made a way for us to find our way back to the tree of life. Look at Ezekiel said that because he considered and turned away. Blessed be the name of God. We can know that the tree of life has been prepared for us.
All right.
Adam just chose the wrong tree. The tree of life was there. God said, Adam,
to dress it.
Yeah.
Look at God honoring Adam.
Yeah.
I'm going to put you in my garden to dress it up.
Yeah.
Adam was like a flower, if you will.
Yeah.
Adam was a beautiful ornament of God.
Yeah.
God told Adam, see, there is the tree of knowledge.
Yeah.
The tree of good and evil. But don't touch it.
Don't touch it.
Blessed be the name of God. But this event of old that we read in Vacation Bible School and Wednesday Bible class, and we read over and over concerning how Adam made his choice. But today, Adam is not the focus. Today, you and I are the focus. Today, you and I must choose. I hear James considering this true life, saying, blessed is the man that endure temptation. Now, I by no means of telling you that you won't be tempted. I just told you there had no temptation taking you. Such as ills coming to me. I just quoted that. But James said, blessed is the man that endure temptation. For when he is tried, he shall receive a crown of life. Look at that, y'all. Listen, for when he is tried, he shall receive a crown of life. Well then, Peter jumped on board to help us out.
All right.
Peter said, beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trials that are come to try you. Test, trials, tribulations will come at the child of God. Why? Because ye and all that live godly must suffer persecution. But then consider, beloved, Peter saying, after a while, he will establish you. He reaches down and uses this Anglo-Saxon word, not establish, but establish you. After a while, he will settle you, strengthen you, and bring you to the point where you say, Lord, I give up. See, because we all at one point tried to get it right ourselves. You can't do it. I remember when I was growing up in high school in mom and dad's house. And I had began to go into a life of smoking marijuana. And I was somewhat embarrassed because I was singing in the choir and still talking. But there had to be a time when I had to allow God to do a work down on the inside of me. Look at James. He said, blessed is the man that endureth temptation. For when he is tried, and you will be tried, saved or unsaved, you will be tried. But dear children of the Lord, I came to encourage you to hold on. Why? Because after you have been tried, God will bring you forth as pure gold. If you hold on to God's unchanging hand, know that God will. He will. He will provide. Paul tells us in the book of Philippi, he says that my God shall, he will supply all of our needs according to his riches and glory. Can I get a witness here? So don't worry and think that you're all in it by yourself. Oh Lord, there is one who will never leave you. you. He will never forsake you. Can I get a witness, church? But the Bible says here, for when he has tried me, I shall receive the crown of life. Isn't that all right? Well, look at Apostle Paul writing to young evangelist Timothy. Well, says Timothy, if you want to receive the crown of life, if you want to hear the Lord say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Well, Timothy, hear what you have got to do. Well, in order to make it back to the tree of life. Can the church say yes?
Yeah.
Timothy, I know that Adam failed in the Garden of Eden. It caused all of mankind to go their own way. But listen here, Timothy, I made a way out of no way. Can the church say yes?
Yeah.
Listen here, Timothy, I've heard God say, it is written of me to do thy will.
Yes,
well, Timothy, no, God has a plan of redemption. Yes, Timothy, no, that the tree of life is not too far away. Well, Timothy, fight a good warfare of faith.
Yeah.
Hold on, Timothy, with all of your life.
Yeah.
Hold on to God's unchanging hand. Yes. Know, Timothy, that God will. He'll lead and guide you. Yes, he will. Know, Timothy, that God is going to send the comforter. Yes, and the comforter is going to lead you and guide you into all truth. Timothy, if you just hold on and fight the good warfare of faith. God will, he will uphold you. Yes, he will. God will, he will console you. Can I get a witness, y'all? Well, I hear the God of peace that gives us the tree of righteousness. I hear the beloved Apostle John say that you can have the tree of life, but you gotta want it. You can have fruits on the tree in the garden, but you got to want it. Look at John in Revelation saying that I saw a pure river of water, yes, as clear as crystal, and the tree of life was in the midst of the tree. Was in the midst of the river where the river ran down the streets of heaven. Yes, John said, I was caught up in the spirit on the Lord's day, and the Lord carried me to that city, and in that city, I saw a river running down through heaven. I looked at the river, and on each side of the river, there was a tree of life on each side. Well, I thought there was just one tree, but John looked again, and John said, I looked down the river that was running through heaven, and John said, I got a good look. I looked on the right side, and there was a tree. I looked on the left side, and there was a tree. And on that tree, there was fruit.